today's Mass is being offered for Robert W. Kinderman, Jr. at the request of Barbara and John Wooden. Please rise, greet our fellow monsignor in the hall, and recite the entrance antiphon. A people who walked in darkness has seen a great light. For those dwelling in a land of deep gloom, a light has shone.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess, O Lord, my God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have raised in my thoughts and my words, what I have done.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord. Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down, and the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him, and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is the 12th day of Christmas, traditionally the day of the Feast of the Epiphany, which we observe on Sunday. And during this week, the Church has provided for us these readings that mark epiphanies, revelations of Jesus as the Son of God and Savior of the world. Today, we see that in the synagogue, in the hometown where he grew up, he finds that passage in Isaiah that basically is the mission that he is entrusted with by the Father, to bring forth the plan for redemption and salvation, identifying himself indeed as the Son of God who has taken on flesh and blood. In our first reading, the letter of St. John, who calls us beloved, who he himself is known as the beloved, invites us to reflect on the reality of God, who is love, calling us into intimate communion with him, and thereby empowering us to live our lives in accordance with the life of God, in accordance with the love of God, thereby loving our brothers and sisters in the way in which God has loved us, because, first and foremost, God has loved us, even in our weakness, in order to set us free and to help us to live according to his Spirit, according to his power, according to his plans. And so we give thanks today to God for these revelations, for the gifts of redemption and salvation, for his power that he has given to us to be all that he has created us to be in intimate communion with him who loves us beyond all human understanding. Let us open our hearts to the Father, pray before him about petitions and needs.
For the Church, may the Holy Spirit bless her and keep her as she proclaims to the world the fullness of the gospel. Let us praise the Lord. For peace throughout the world, may God enable the spirit of understanding and reconciliation to prevail in all hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are enslaved by addictions, may the Lord break their chains and lead them to a path of freedom and new life. Let us pray to the Lord. For members of our faith community, may the grace of the sacraments help us grow in our love for one another. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may Christ our Savior have mercy on their souls and welcome them to his heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. For the sick and suffering, Jerry Reynolds, Ken Rowley, Colin Licker, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord. And for Robert W. Kinderman Jr., for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Saving Father, we hear these prayers we have brought before you and answer them in accordance with your most holy will. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
have given, we may learn to receive your very self through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. We have our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and divisions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, to celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one. Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our bishop, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Say said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever."
Amen. Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
And we pray, Almighty God, that by the power of these holy mysteries, our life may be constantly sustained through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And all peace, glorify the Lord by your name.
Thanks be to God.
May our God defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness of the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and endow the prince of the heavenly host by the power of